Hello. Is it me you're looking for? I can see it in your eyes.
Oh, that's all that did. Okay. Hey guys, it's your boy DJ HardLogic here, coming at you with another episode of Survival Minecraft on the Java Survival Server, episode 52. And I just finished another session of mining. I only did a one long session instead of a two long like last time, but I still got 36 diamonds, which is pretty good. I need to quit doing long sentences. I'm just going back up to my base real quick to get all this stuff sorted out. Still haven't found my nether pick. Welcome back. And I'll catch you up when I get back up there. So in today's episode, I'm going to be doing a little bit of redstone stuff. Well, I guess actually a lot of bit of redstone stuff with my logic box there. But I need to get some stuff. What I'm going to be doing is making a lottery machine, which I know requires a lot of glass. Oh, wait, no, I need to empty all my stuff. That's not where that goes. Where's my other stuff? Oh. Boop, 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 boop. Okay. Oh, I forgot to put my water bucket down there. Oh, well. So now I need to get a bunch of glass and a bunch of sand. I need to put my shovel away. I need a lot more glass than that. I'll need to go get some more glass, so I won't be putting my shovel away. Remember putting that there. Oh well, I need to get it anyways. Now I need to get more sand. Well, I've just come back to where I'm going to be building it real quick. Not because I need to start building it, but anyone because I actually want to sand? See how much. I don't know. But because I want to see how much glass I actually need, so I need to get. Actually, I don't think I do need to get. Do I need to get? No, I don't think I need to get. Let's just go to schematics and lottery material list. Okay, so white stained glass. I can turn this into a learning lesson about Litematica. For those who are interested, I'm sure a lot of you probably aren't, but for those who are, here we go. So what I've done is I've gone into the materials list. So these are all the materials used in this build, which I do believe also includes any barrier blocks, which I don't think there are any for this specific schematic I did. I currently have this listed by total number. By the total number of blocks being used, the most is the white stained glass, of which I need 890. Now, I can't really move my cursor to show you, so I'll just kind of do this in post, but here it shows 13 times 64, so I need 64 stacks plus another 58, which is also this many shulker boxes, which is only helpful if you need like a ton of it that will be in several shulker boxes. This one I only need 2 stacks plus another 21. This one I need 1 stack plus another 36. But right now I'm just focusing on the white stained glass, and so I need 13. And right now I only have 1, 2, 3, 4, basically 5. So I need another 8 plus, what was it, 36 or something? Oh, plus, I basically need 14 stacks. So let's go get those stacks. So I went a little overboard, but that's kind of intentional because I wanted to have some more sand in my reserves here. So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So all the rest of this can go into here for later use. And now I'm going to go smelt up this sand into glass. And then I can use my auto bone meal farm, wherever that went, over here. How far up is it now? Ooh! Oh, nice! I can use that as my dye. I don't know if I actually described how that works or not, but I can in just a moment. After I do all that, Okay, so I'm going to go into free cam mode, like that, which is allowed on here for doing redstone and for making videos. So the way that my farm works is that it takes all the byproduct or overflow from all my farms. So farms like my kelp farm, iron farm with its cat, the iron farm with its bread flowers, and something else. Sugarcane farm. They all go into individual composters or composters, whichever way you want to say it, that go over here and into here. Occasionally, it does have an overflow indicator for this system as well. And if it gets more than one at a time, then it'll accidentally overflow. But since it's a byproduct farm, it doesn't really matter. Anyways, let's see how far we've gotten. Alright. Pretty good. So now that I have all that white stained glass, you can see now that this number here has changed. It was red, now it's orange. That means that I have it somewhere in me, either just in my inventory or in a shulk box, which is what I've done. I put all of it in a shulk box. Available, that's how much I have to use, because that's actually how much I have on me. If it's both green, then that means that all of it has been used, such as all of these lamps here. But now I'm just gonna take screenshots. Actually, I don't technically need to take screenshots, but I'm gonna take screenshots. I'm gonna take screenshots of all of this material list, so that way I know how much I actually need of each thing. But I also could do this, write the file, which means that it just literally makes a Word document. And it just automatically saves it, I think, to your desktop. Maybe. Anyways, I'm going to keep gathering some of these resources, and then I'll get back to you once I start building. I could be crazy, but I don't remember my shulker box being this barren. It doesn't mean it wasn't. I do usually whenever I have projects like this, it tends to use a lot of resources. I just don't remember it being that empty. Oh well. Okay, I do believe that I have everything that I need between all these shulker boxes and just a little bit that's in my inventory. So I'm going to go head over to the shopping district and build a lottery. There we have it, all dusted and done and dusted and dusted. I didn't really add putting the casing around it because, one, I didn't realize that these needed to actually be concrete. I did everything as wool instead, just to make it a little bit easier to get the materials. And two, I actually needed to get one more sign to fill in one of the hoppers and also get filler items for the filter so that it only actually does diamonds. But this is how it works. Or not how it works, but this is how it looks. I would usually show you on here how it works, but I really don't want to put my own money into the lottery just because there's only one way of getting it back, and that's to win. But I can show you in a creative world, so let's go do that. But instead of just stumbling over my words by just going straight into it, I'm going to read from a book that I made specifically to teach people how this works, and I'll stumble over that instead. The trap chest locks the hopper below so players can change their minds about how much they want to put in. The diamonds are moved to a dropper that sends a signal to a counter above it that determines if the minimum prize pool has been reached, at which point the lights at the top will turn on. The diamonds go through a water stream bubble column that leads to a modified item filter designed to accommodate the space. The six observers next to it are what keep the item flow running smoothly, and also keeps the diamonds from getting ejected from the system. The item filter is connected to the prize divider that separates the small prize from the rest. Diagram 1 shows the chest and hoppers and how they're related without the pistons in front, and then with the pistons and redstone blocks is diagram 2. The top pistons lock the hoppers to provide paths to the correct prizes. When the button is pressed, it sends a pulse through daisy-chained randomizers with the following contents. They each have one non-stackable item and 8 stackable items. In the first one, the check marks are the win conditions and the X's are the lose conditions. In the second one, the check mark is a small prize and the X means jackpot. In both cases, check marks are non-stackable and X's are stackable. These signals are monitored by the hopper comparator output. If X, the signal takes the jackpot path and both prize pools empty. If check mark, then the signal is overridden and only the small prize is emptied. The jackpot will continue to grow until it is won. Both signals will turn off the lights at the top and reset the counter at the start. And that's about everything in here. So let's get back to the server. Well, that's all the time I have for today, and like I said before, it did pretty well deplete most of my supplies, though I did pretty much only get enough supplies to do what I needed. But if you guys had fun, consider leaving a like, and if you had a lot of fun, consider subscribing. I'll see you in the next one.